Hello and welcome to PC World. I am Hayden Dingman and I am here with Adam Patrick Murray.
Hey, that's me. We're playing some South Park, huh?
We are playing South Park, the Fractured Butthole.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't think you can say that on this video.
I can't say butthole.
As long as you're referring
it's
to
spelled,
something that's
it's
not.
It's spelled B-U-T space. W-H-O-L-E.
Oh, okay. I get it. Oh, it's South Park, huh?
Yeah, it is that wacky South Park humor. We should mention that this is probably an adults-only video.
We'll see.
I'm pretty sure.
Then turn off your ears and exit YouTube as quickly as you can if you're going to be offended.
But yeah, this is a sequel to South Park, The Stick of Truth, the Obsidian game that came out, 2014, I think.
Yeah, it's been a bit. There.
That one was all fantasy themed. This one is superhero themed, as you can tell from our little clothes
here.
And there are quite a few clothing options. In fact, we can jump in and look at some. We got all sorts of fake Iron Man and the bra on the head, this great unicorn outfit.
Perfect. Majestic unicorn is what it said.
Yeah, all sorts of prison outfit, boulder suit. I've collected all these. I mean, when you start out, there's like, you know, very basic stuff. I'm about 10 hours in now, so we've collected a lot of dumb clothes.
It's just through the normal course of play, right?
Yep. It's just I mean, you can buy them from kiosks in the game, but it's just in-game money, so no loot boxes or like that in here.
Good.
We can put on these shutter shades if we want.
Nice. Do they actually affect gameplay at all?
It's just for cosmetic looks. So I have worn a lot of dumb stuff in this game so far. We also have powers. We have three different classes at this point. At this point in the game, you can choose three out of, I think, eight classes to be. So you can see we are a blaster, cyborg, gadgeteer, with all these different powers to choose from. But right now we are going to go to see Cartman.
Who's that?
A character in South Park.
Oh, okay.
A little fat kid. So we're going to go talk to him, see what the next step is. This game is
broken
up into...
I knew who Cartman is.
This game is broken up into days. The first game was more freeform. This one, every single day, some new stuff happens, and you end up like going to bed at night. So we have just woken up on the third day out of five, I believe. We have to get into our...
Okay, here's Farty Pants now. Come join us.
Oh, yes. I totally forgot there's a fart button.
Yes. There are actually two fart buttons.
So we saw this at PAX like a year and a half ago.
Yeah, this game was supposed to come out almost a year ago. Maybe that's worth mentioning. This game was supposed to come out in December of 2016.
Yeah.
And is now coming out 10 months later. I don't know what the reason for the delay was. It seemed fine when we played at PAX last year, I guess took them a while to get this polished up. It seems fine now. I haven't noticed any big problems. There is one glitch where the controller rumble just never stops. So I have to occasionally hit.
Wait, you're playing this on a PC with a controller?
Yeah, I am. That's a good thing to mention. The mouse and keyboard controls are garbage.
Oh no.
There are a lot of like QuickTime event type things in this game, some of them are built so on the controller you like push an analog stick in a certain direction or like turn it in circles or something, and when you do that on a keyboard you just end up like tapping the keys back and forth and it feels really awkward.
That sounds great.
It's clearly designed for a controller and I would recommend it, but. Butters is like Dr. Chaos or Professor Chaos or something. We beat him at the end of the second night, threw him in jail, and now we are following him out to go to his house.
Okay.
So,
also, I should say, when we saw this at PAX, you were also equipped with the Nauseous Rift.
Yeah, the fart machine, basically.
Yeah, that's a good video if you go back and watch that, because he... you literally torture yourself and see how many farts you can
handle.
Yeah,
no fart machine for the actual release, which is a bit of a shame.
Yeah. I was hoping they'd delay it to have that at launch, but no.
So yeah, we've got our phone. That's our main means of interacting. It's where our map is kept and all that.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember where Butters lives. So that is... Oh, it's right next door to Carmen. Great.
Perfect.
So yeah, we'll head next door.
You're about to enter the chamber of chaos, new kid. There's no way to unsee the horror.
Are these built-in achievements that keep popping up for
yes,
the game?
Yes, probably.
I haven't cleaned up for a while, so watch where you're stepping. No, that's not it.
So yeah, I mean, no. The game is pretty similar to Stick of Truth.
Uh-huh.
It's just like...
well, what did you think of Stick of Truth when it came out?
I liked it. So I'll say this about Fractured But Whole, is I thought that Stick of Truth, a lot of the jokes were just like reference humor. Like it was like, hey, remember this time this joke happened? Which is funny because if you've seen South Park recently, there's like the whole member berries shtick where they are just like making fun of that sort of nostalgia. And so it's a little ironic that their first game was like basically built around that. But this one I think is a much better at like actually doing a story and then like integrating the reference humor in a better way.
And so Professor Chaos.
So yeah, we just got grounded.
Oh great. That takes me back.
Since we're teenagers now.
And it looks like we're gonna end up building a flying guinea pig to get out of here.
Nice.
If I had to guess from what I'm collecting right now.
So is my new friend or I'm grounded.
Oh no, test pilot. I see where this is going.
Oh, so if we go into this like detective mode, we can throw farts at people. We can also throw cherry bombs to make parts of the scenery fall down.
Okay, that's it's kind of funny.
There's a lot of maybe we have to, I guess we can't just climb on the bed. That would be crazy.
I mean, look at their legs. They can barely walk, you know.
All right, so I think we're going to go ahead and craft.
Oh, crafting. Every game has got
it. So, yeah, we got crafting. You can see that I have not engaged with it much, which is why I have 999 plus of everything. But you can craft different costume parts, so I have been doing that.
Oh, okay.
And you also have to craft some mission items occasionally. So...
But for the most part, the actual like gameplay loop hasn't really changed much, right?
No, it's pretty much. I mean, you unlock more powers over time, but a lot of this stuff is just like if you needed it. I'm also playing on like this standard difficulty, and mm-hmm. to be honest, I kind of wish I'd played on the higher difficulty, like the maximum, because I don't think the combat is very tough.
Oh, huh.
But yeah, I think we're about to throw this hamster. Or this guinea pig up here?
No, don't do it.
I'm not sure, but that does seem like where this is going. Maybe we have to unlock this window.
Oh, there we go. Oh, what? That?
Well, I guess not that.
okay. That's kind of funny. But at least... So it lets you kill yourself, but then it drops you right back where you were.
Yeah, it drops you right back where you were.
So that's nice.
I don't know what we're supposed to do. Yeah, I got the electric lock part.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no. I don't know what we're supposed to do here. Well, this is live, so...
We're trying to figure... Yeah, trying to figure out... All the quests. Did you craft the...
I crafted my hamster. Guinea pig.
Oh,
I just have to give it to him.
Oh, you just
got to
give it to him. That's it.
Oh, that's easy.
Oh, easy. Oh, look how cute he is. I had a hamster once.
Okay, yeah. So now we're going to do exactly what I thought, which is... so we have these buddy powers, and...
You say buddy or bunny?
Buddy. So, like, all of the different... characters that you run into each have a specific power.
Mm-hmm.
So Captain Diabetes will he gets enraged if you fart in his face and then knocks over heavy objects. Human Kite will jump on your back and then you can fart your way up to ledges.
Okay.
This one allows you to It's a sandblaster, and usually you would need compressed air to run it, but as you can probably guess, the compressed air is farts in this case. So he puts a tube in your rectum. And now I guess we have this new one, which is this flying guinea pig.
Wait.
And I bet we're going to fart it up there.
Oh, no.
Well,
all right. Yep. Okay.
Oh, South Park.
Yeah. Why not?
So yeah, now we've opened the door.
Okay. All right.
There's a lot of fart humor in this game.
I get it.
Couldn't guess.
Oh, goodness.
So yeah, all of these powers then open up new parts of the world. There have been a couple of garages that I couldn't get into so far because they have been locked with that same sort of electronic lock. And so now it's like, we can go back
that's
in.
Impossible. How could you be here right now?
It wasn't me, Dad. It was a new kid.
You.
The new kid doesn't seem to be talking, right?
Yeah. How do they address that? You just never talk. They make jokes about it. Uh-huh. Like they'll be like, hey, what's your name? Just never.
Yeah.
Say anything. It looks like we're gonna get a little taste of combat here, fighting against his dad. So that's good. This will be a good place to stop after we've beaten this guy. So, it's pretty similar to the first game, in terms of. It's all on a... So the first game was turn-based, like a JRPG, but it was all, traditional JRPG where you were just, standing on your side.
Uh-huh.
This one has a bit more complexity. It's a grid system.
Huh.
And...
Your relation to the character you're fighting matters?
Yeah. So we have, you can see down in the bottom left, we have a bunch of powers, and the powers are all... they show, where on the grid they're going to affect.
Okay.
For instance, if we... pull up X, we could attack him, light him on fire. But in this case, all of our buddies are grounded, and so we want to unground them, which we do with this power, I believe. That should then let Human Kite join our fight.
Nice. Now, does each character have a class kind of system? Or?
Yeah. Yeah, so everybody has... they're all kind of what you would expect. Human Kite has his kite based powers and stuff. I don't know what Butters is yet because I haven't used him. And Call Girl is our fourth one right now.
Uh-huh.
She has a bunch of phone based powers.
Nice.
And yeah, you can see there are quick time events happening also. Those are how you do criticals. You have to time it correctly. Butters is going to get.
Ooh.
So we can actually pause time and skip his turn.
By farting,
yeah.
Of course. Okay.
So now we'll light him on fire because that's the easiest way to get a bunch of characters down. They lose health every single turn. So. Uh-huh. But yeah, I've actually really enjoyed the combat. It's a lot more engaging than the first game because the first game was a lot of once you figured out the pattern, you just kind of did it over and over.
Yeah.
By putting this on a grid, it gives you a lot more options.
Wait, what's that? What's that meter up top? What is that?
So that's our ultimate meter. When that gets to the top, we can unfreeze another character.
Oh, okay. So
we're probably gonna unfreeze Butters this time. There's also
you're supposed to stay grounded.
Each character has a different ultimate, so the Human Kite flies up a million feet in the air and then shoots lasers down.
Uh-huh.
And you as a butthole kid, you just fart on everybody in this huge storm.
No way.
Yeah, so Professor Chaos, I don't know what any of these powers do, but so this one will confuse and shock them. This one will just shoot them. We'll probably use that this turn. But yeah, it's just a lot more engaging, and you can see these red stripes on the ground right now.
Uh-huh.
That means that anybody that's stuck in that area when he gets his next turn is going to get hurt.
Or could potentially?
I will get hurt. So that's you usually want to get out of those areas as best you can.
Okay.
It can't be grounded. It's like a miracle you
Yeah, so in this case, he grounds anybody, I guess, that's in those areas again. So all the people that you just unlocked get grounded for a second time.
Nice. And do you have an unlimited, like, rewinds, or?
No, so you can see this meter at the bottom.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering.
We have to wait one more turn.
Oh, okay.
To unground, or to do that again.
And why are the little cards in the bottom right electrified?
That's because we have our ultimate unlocked right now. Anybody that is on our team has that. I'm about ready to detonate some. And yeah, we can. Yeah, let's just use our ultimate so you can get a look at it. And so, yeah, like, all the ultimates, the same as the first game, are all, like, really crazy art styles and stuff. I've really enjoyed them. In, like, yours, when you fart on everybody, he swallows fire, and then you, like, go down his esophagus.
Oh, goodness.
And, okay. See him fart, so.
I see where that's going.
You know what you did. Ground it!
So how many boss encounters are like this? Is it pretty often, or?
Yeah, it's fairly often.
Or is this considered a boss, or is this?
Yeah, this is kind of like a mini boss. There was a battle at the end of the second night, mm-hmm. Against Butters as Chaos, mm-hmm. and it was like a 3-stage battle, same as old games maybe. So that was a lot of fun. But yeah, in general, probably like twice a day, there's like an actual boss battle.
Okay. And you said this is currently at day 3?
Yeah, this is day 3. And yeah, I'm having a lot of fun with the battles. I think that the way they do this combat has been pretty smart. The first game was like good at combat stuff, but, by the end, as I said, you kind of just had like an idea of what to do every time. This one, there's a lot more they can do because it's played out on a grid to mm-hmm. switch it up every time. And like all of the different classes seem pretty fun. So like this turn, right, like all of us are got out of that grounding mm-hmm. area. So now we don't have to worry when he takes his next turn, nobody's going to end up grounded again.
Nice.
There's also, because it's all on a grid, they can have a lot of, there are a lot of characters that you end up taking to get access to certain moves. So Call Girl, for instance, that last move affects like pretty much the entire board from wherever she is.
Oh, wow.
And so it's like much more useful than a lot of the moves that other characters have, where it affects like 2 squares in front of them or something like that.
Hmm.
So yeah,
oh, was we'll that he- a, like a healing?
Yeah, kind of? We'll heal up. You know what you did. Ground it. We can nice. Also, there are different summons. Maybe I'll do one of those on this next turn. There are summons that you can build.
Mm-hmm.
I'll ground you. I'll ground you.
And he's going to ground the entire
thing
next time.
I'll take this call, guys.
I think we can win on this turn, though.
Say cheese.
You got a lot of nerve, kid.
You're up, Ass Blaster.
So yeah, I'll pull out a summon just so we can see them.
Let's do it.
Yeah, we'll bring out Cheese Gerald.
Nice.
Same thing. These are all like very crazy illustrations.
I mean, they obviously put a lot of time in this.
Yeah. They definitely have like built on the combat a lot more than the last game.
Okay.
So yeah. And then we can actually, since we have our ultimate too, we can do that to finish out this battle. That'll probably be a good way to end.
Nice. Nice.
So yeah,
Butters, you're grounded for life.
We beat up his dad.
I am? I don't feel grounded. Yes, I'm not grounded. I'm ungroundable.
No!
Nice.
And we
good
got
job,
a 1979
team.
Men's underwear catalog.
Oh, perfect.
As our reward.
And $4.30.
So yeah, I think it's a pretty fun game. My dad regains consciousness. There's obviously an abundance of dumb humor.
I mean, if you like South Park, you know where you're getting into.
Yeah,
right?
I feel like that's sort of the thing. Like, there's some stuff that I've been pretty iffy on, but I don't know. I think in general, like, it is just a South Park game.
Yeah.
And does that pretty well. And like playing it is great. That's the difference to me between this one and the first one. The first one I felt like was a decent game that was like a good South Park game.
Uh-huh.
I feel like this one is actually a very good game. Like I have enjoyed all the combat stuff and the exploration has been great. There's just a lot more stuff to explore every time. And then like the story has been good enough. It's fine.
Yeah. it'll do.
Yeah. It's good enough to like wrap around this game. So yeah, I don't know. Nice. That's South Park.
All right.
And this is out on Tuesday.
It's a full price game, right?
Yes. This is a full price game from Ubisoft. That is the one thing is we are using Uplay.
Oh, yay. Yay for Uplay.
But yeah, it is a full price game out on Tuesday and one of Ubisoft's only games this year. So
wow.
We'll see how it does.
To take us out, why don't you fart on
these
people. Keep your gas in your ass, Pecky. Okay. Thanks, Aiden.
Yep. Thanks, Adam.